A digital revolution is underway in medicine and biomedical research, thanks in large part to new wearable technologies like smartwatches and fitness bands.
20 years ago, the only way to find out something more about yourself is if you actually went to a clinic. But wearables and smartphones have completely changed that. And our job, I see it now as care providers, is to make sense of all the data that's being generated.
At the Scripps Research Translational Institute, scientists are taking full advantage of these technologies to study disease and also help patients.
Well, we were very lucky here to be able to pull together the first large digitized clinical trial. And we diagnosed thousands of people who unknowingly had atrial fibrillation. So what we learned through that project several years ago, we could do transformative medical research and help people without ever having met them.
So, how do digital trials work? Typically, participants visit a website or download an app, consent to share data from their smartwatch, fitness tracker, or other device, and then answer some questions. Participants can even collect biosamples like blood or saliva at home, and then send them back in the mail. Researchers are able to gather data from thousands of users remotely, making study participation both convenient and easy. The data is processed with artificial intelligence to find patterns in things like heart rate, blood sugar, activity, and sleep. Through careful analysis, researchers are able to find correlation between data and disease, and in some cases, even predict illness before diagnosis. The digital approach also enables scientists to easily communicate information back to the participant.
As an example, we have launched Detect, our study for COVID-19. We have continuous sensor data from this large amount of people, and we can start asking and answering questions like, can sensor data help in the detection of COVID-19 and other viral illnesses?
For PROGRESS, which is our prediction of glycemic response study, we're capturing their glucose response in real time.
We look at the sleep data from their device and also ask them to fill out different sort of questionnaires on how they think they sleep.
The All of Us Research Program is an NIH-led initiative to recruit 1 million folks all across the United States to share information about themselves and their health and their environment.
The Paramount platform, not only does it provide resources, but it provides a tool that you can show your provider, hey, this is what's going on with me. This is different from me. I need you to listen to me.
You finally make it in to see your doctor at about 8 to 10 weeks, and then you may go in every month or so. This really allows a pregnant person to track their activity, their sleep, their resting heart rate throughout their pregnancy.
As wearable sensors become more advanced and accessible, new possibilities emerge.
The sensor that gets me most excited is actually imaging. So here you're taking a probe that gets high resolution ultrasound, and you connect it to the base of the smartphone, and you can image any part of the human body, your body. And now we're seeing automatic interpretations that are really good for screening. So this is a revolution that's just getting legs right now, but the implications of it are vast.
And the revolution goes beyond digital devices. Researchers are also incorporating participants' own genomic data, our DNA, to evaluate individual risk of disease.
My Gene Rank is an app that we built to communicate coronary artery disease and eventually other disease risk to individuals. So anyone can download it, connect their pre-existing genetic data, we'll calculate a genetic risk score as well as a clinical risk score, and return that to the individuals.
Moving us closer to a world where anyone can get individualized care, often from the comfort of their own home.
So what we're trying to do is understand each human being through many levels, whether that's genomics, whether that's through digital sensors, through their anatomy, through their environment, all these different levels of their immune system, that we can understand why that person is unique and be responsive to a prevention or a treatment or make a more accurate diagnosis.
The grand vision really is to make hospitals available only for procedures and ICU level care. We know that people just heal better at home. And if we can empower that home for monitoring, for care delivery, we really can make that reality of providing hospital care at home for most cases.